presently in Nigeria, we experience shortage of electricity and water, and the percentage of those who now access electricity is equally high. There are many few sources of electricity generation in Nigeria, which is from fossil fuel, thermal, hydro, and only less than 1% is from wind. This is showing some of the grid, marginal grid, I think 330 KVA as a way of maybe understanding some of the accessibility concept of energy, I summarize this from authors which they have narrated or described access to electricity as having more connection, household connection to the national grid as well as affordability. But I think, in my opinion, that access to equally account for availability, reliability, as well as affordability. The aim of this study is to evaluate electricity challenges in Nigeria as part of ongoing reforms in the sector with a view to contributing to the national and global energy issues for poverty today. The study uses official information from National Grid, Nigerian Utility, NEMA, and secondary sources of CO2. Currently, this is the accessibility rate. Our accessibility proposal of each of the geopolitical zones. So you can see southwest and south-south tend to have the highest accessibility ratio compared to places in North Central and North Central. Yes, this is the proportion of Nigerian accessibility per state. And we can see there's a huge problem, particularly with areas around the northern part of the country. This is the government spending. This is the government spending from 1999 to date, 2014, in terms of contribution to the generation of electricity in Nigeria. And Nigeria, with an estimated 170 million population, can only produce 31 of electricity per person, while countries like South Africa generate about over 1,000 watts of electricity per person. And we can see the comparison between the investment and the generation of electricity in Nigeria. Maybe we need to take some of the slide. The MDS shows that electricity generation only account for 1% of the national GDP. So there is a huge potential for investment and what we're doing in the sector. And the development industry shows that the provision of adequate grid electricity will transform Nigeria's economy, which is a fact that every country the way forward is part of the privatization issue which the country engaged in. And we know, of course, the stories that happened and the withdrawal of subsidy with regards to the fuel and the electricity and the water bill and the billing system as well and the increment of the tariff. You know, these are all part of the modalities that the government put in place to promote the efficiency of electricity generation in the country. So, as part of summary, Nigeria continued to improve the quality of the existing dilapidated infrastructure. However, there is the requirement to look outside the box. While it is good that the country should use certain technology to improve the electricity generation, issues such as vandalization of facilities and of course the crazy meter bills and what have you should be eliminated. More emphasis should be given to curtailing corruption that is endemic in that sector. Most of the things I have said, I just make it in summary, is in the paper for those of us that.
Thank you. This your title of clean energy. You didn't say anything about it. And I think it's very, very important for you to elaborate on that.
The point is in the paper.
No, the presentation.
Time, it's just 5 minutes.
Okay, okay.
Excuse me.
You put the southwest and the north central to have about the least access. Because I know these areas by the demand and supply, they get more of this energy consumed in those areas from the national grid. So I don't tend to. You can reconcile that. If you can get back to that,
I think you're thinking of the.
Please let us have
Which of the slides? Is it this one?
Okay, I've seen this thing. You're talking about electricity. Household without electricity access.
Please let us have two more, please, so that. Two more. Yes, from one, two. Please.